Good afternoon. Welcome. Welcome. Well, my name is Peter Fagan. I'm the president of the Milwaukee Bucks and probably one of the luckiest guys in the world to have the opportunity to make announcements like this. This is an incredibly important day for our franchise and an exciting day for basketball fans across the state of Wisconsin. We couldn't be more pleased to be here today and announce that the Milwaukee Bucks have purchased a D-League team and have decided to play in Oshkosh right here. So when our owners bought the Milwaukee Bucks almost 3 years ago, one of the goals was how to build basketball in the state of Wisconsin. Truly, this is the biggest opportunity, and this should and will be our state's game. And Greg Pierce and his team here in the Fox Valley actually helped make this dream come to fruition. So I want to thank Greg Pierce and his team here at Oshkosh. The passion, the appetite, the thirst that this community has had for a D-League team and to partner with the Milwaukee Bucks has just been overwhelming and incredible. We can't be more thankful. We can't be more excited to start this today together to really help rebuild like the city of Oshkosh, much like we're doing in the city of Milwaukee. So we've got a little bit of a lead in what redevelopment, what transformation means, and kind of joining the vision of really what a professional team can do for a community. We're very excited today to kind of launch this with our D-League team. We'll also talk about the necessity of operating a D-League team. Today, we're very lucky to have the Bucks general manager, John Hammond, who will go further into the importance of operationally, how do we create a championship team with the Bucks, and how vital a D-League team is to really make that, and how this D-League team is truly, it's not part of the fabric of the Bucks, it is the Bucks, which is a great extension of our brand, of our family, of our community. We couldn't be more excited to be here. We've got an unbelievable tradition of basketball here in the state of Wisconsin. In fact, 1971, as most of you know, we won a championship, and I think we have Bob Dandridge in the crowd who was on that time. Bob, are you here? Bob Dandridge, he says. But we know we have nothing on the legacy of Oshkosh basketball, which I'm sure all of you are very aware of how the Flyers and how the Fox Valley has been ingrained in the history of professional basketball over time. This is an unbelievable opportunity for us to kind of join that tradition in a neat way and almost kind of reinvent professional basketball in this area. And we're beyond excited to be in there. So with that, what I'd really like to do, and we're very proud and humbled to have him here, I'd like to introduce the president of the NBA D-League, Mr. Malcolm Turner.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And what a terrific reception. We are so thrilled to be here and appreciate you being here. Certainly want to thank Peter Fagan and John Hammond and the entire Milwaukee Bucks organization and their ownership group, Mark Lazary, Wes Edens, Jamie Dimon. We're thrilled to expand and grow our relationship with the Milwaukee Bucks organization in this fashion. The NBA Development League is growing, as testament of this announcement today. We're already at a record 22 teams for this season, but with this announcement, Milwaukee and our new home here in Oshkosh is really the headline for our 17-18 class, which will bring us to 25 teams for the 2017-18 season. So we're very thrilled to be here with a record 25 teams. This announcement also means that now 20 of our NBA teams will own and operate their own NBA Development League team. So just another further proof point of the value that this league is serving for the development needs at the NBA level. Oshkosh, we've been thrilled, knowing that this announcement's coming, and again, the reception that we have here today. We're so excited, looking forward to opening night to introduce an exciting, fun, family-friendly brand of basketball that is the NBA Development League. And, you know, what's really happening within this league is very exciting. The level of talent has never been stronger. And NBA players are being assigned to this league at record levels. Rookie development is taking place within this league at an unprecedented rate. So we're really looking forward to opening night. Thank you for being here. We're so excited to now call Oshkosh as part of our family of NBA Development League markets. Thank you very much. And now I'd like to introduce Milwaukee Bucks General Manager John Hammond.
Thank you. Thank you very much. From a basketball operations standpoint, I can't tell you how excited we are to be here. When you talk about the NBA Developmental League and what it means to teams around the NBA, for us to continue to develop towards a championship caliber team and a championship caliber organization, we have to have this. We have to be a part of the Developmental League. So this is a great opportunity for us, and we couldn't be more excited. As Malcolm was stated, you look around NBA rosters today and you can see players who are NBA signees, now in NBA rosters, players who have started their careers in the NBA Developmental League, now playing in the league itself. So it's a great tool for players to hone their skills that are part of NBA rosters and develop into NBA players, or players that get a start in this league, in the Developmental League, that will play in the league itself someday. Player development is a constant throughout the NBA, and there's no greater tool in today's development than the Developmental League. It's something that we have to have, and so excited to be here. With that being said, I just want to say this, though. You know, the real crux of today is about Oshkosh and us being here in Oshkosh, and we are so excited for the opportunity to be here. You know, in the visits that we had with the city leaders, with others on the committee that helped to bring this team here to Oshkosh, we feel very secure that this is where we're supposed to be, this is where we wanted to be, and this is where we're going to call home. Thank you very much.
Definitely coming back over to Peter, just give it to you.
I think you can give it to me. I think we'll do the transition. So this is one of the better parts of the program. I'll take you back probably a year and a half ago when we got a call, and Lori Hoke, who's here. Lori, are you here? I know you don't want to be pointed out, but the person who started the process, who called one day and said, "Hey, I've got a great friend in Oshkosh. You should talk to these guys. It'd be an unbelievable place to have a D-League team." That's how it started. And probably within 12 or 14 hours, my partner Alex Lazary gave a call to Greg Pierce and Ted Lorke, two guys who deserve a lot of credit to getting us to where we are today in actually having a team on the ground, and started the conversation with a man who has single-handedly, and again, we're a team of about 20 that have been able to handle this, with Greg as being really the quarterback of a team to get this done in Oshkosh. I can't tell you, out of all of the activity, all the operations, all the buildings, all the neat things we've had in the Milwaukee Bucks over the last 2.5 years, there's not been a better partner. There's been not a better person with business acumen, and more importantly, interpersonal skills to make us all feel great about what we're doing in Oshkosh than Greg Pierce. We are beyond thrilled to be with his team and to be with the city. And with that, I'll introduce Greg Pierce.
Thanks, Pete. I'll pay up later. Thank you. This is for everyone behind me and everyone in the crowd. I apologize up front. This is my Academy Awards, and you are not playing me off. First, everybody in town, can you believe it? We're real excited, and this by far is not a one-person show. First, I want to thank my partners at Windward Wealth, who is Kim Molitor, Walt Koskinen, and Cass Knight. They have been spectacular. We got there on a crazy idea that actually, as you flesh it out, became a pretty doggone good idea. And those three helped me, and we did it together. Also, by far, the most important person in this process for us has been Jason White and his team at the Greater Economic Development Corporation. I'll tell you what. By the time we got here, I think I worked for him. He single-handedly helped us work through all the things we had to do when it came to stuff with the public sector, the city, just working through the process, and made it really easy. So Jason absolutely made this deal happen for us. I don't know if we could have done it without him. Also, the city, I'll tell you what, Mayor Cummings and Mark Roloff, who are coming up, I was a little worried that I needed to work with the public sector to get this done, and I was wrong. The process with the city have been spectacular. They were as charged up about this idea as about anyone. So I do want to make sure we thank Steve, the city council, and manager Mark Roloff. So by the way, I'm going to make it really clear. I have a bet with some of these guys up on stage about how many season tickets we're going to get deposits for tonight. So please help me out. I'm going to owe big if we don't hit that number. So I need you to show that we support this venture, because I'll tell you what, I've gone around town the last 12 months, and the support we've had in this community have been off the charts. We know that the community will embrace this, and we're excited to have the Bucks here in Oshkosh. But I'll tell you what I've been saying for the last 9 months is that this deal is not a basketball deal. This deal is about redevelopment. We specifically are going to be on the Buck staff site on South Main at South Park for the reason that we think we can be a catalyst for significant change and moving this city forward in a place that's needed it. There is so much that can come from this building and the resource it does provide the community, and the resource it provides to do other events besides basketball. My friends up on the stage here are going to provide me with 40 or 50 days of things to do. I have 300 open days that the community needs to tell me what can we use it for. So also, believe it or not, our friends that are our builders at Bayland also continue to believe we will be ready to go for this season. And I know nobody believes it. I believe in them. I think it's going to happen. I think we're going to be just fine. When we get it done, everyone should thank Bayland for pulling off, frankly, a pretty significant task. And we're excited to work with them. So once again, I know I'm going to miss tons of people I should have thanked, and this room is full of those people. Just know that I give you my heartfelt thanks. We are excited about the journey we're going to undertake, because now the real work begins. And I just want to thank the city of Oshkosh for everything they've done for us. Thank you. Now I want to introduce our mayor, Mayor Steve Cummings.
Thank you, Greg. What a great day for the 67,000 people that call this fantastic city home. Give yourselves a hand. I want to thank the Milwaukee Bucks organization for making the right choice to locate the D-League team here in Wisconsin's Event City. Your wisdom will be awarded with a great location along the shores of Lake Winnebago, a new arena for your team to call home, and a supportive fan base that has anxiously been waiting for this announcement for a few months, more than a few months. I want to thank Greg Pierce and Fox Valley Pro Basketball for the vision to bring professional baseball, basketball back to Oshkosh. It's been a lot of decades. I appreciate the faith you put in our community, and I appreciate the faith and enthusiasm our community has put in you and your organization and vision. Another big thank you goes to the local partners who helped Greg with his proposal. In particular, I want to thank Jason White and his staff at Greater Oshkosh Economic Development Corporation for their research and the legwork to assist Greg and his group to put Oshkosh in such an incredibly positive light. Of course, I want to thank my visionary colleagues on the Oshkosh Common Council, many of whom are here today, Deputy Mayor Deb Ellison Osby, Councilman Tom Peck, Steve Herman, Lori Palmieri, Ben Stepanek, and Caroline Pansky. I also want to thank the members of the Oshkosh Plan Commission for their support of the project and recognizing what it will mean to our central city. And last, but certainly not least, I want to acknowledge all of the behind-the-scenes work that was done by city staff, City Manager Roloff, Community Development Director Alan Davis, Economic Development Manager Kelly Nineforth, and Planning Services Manager Darren Burrish. There are many others who made this a reality, and it's all about teamwork and the commitment to keep Oshkosh moving forward. Their efforts will transform an area that has been blighted for decades into the crown jewel of Oshkosh. We have a long and proud history of being known for producing high-quality products and offering an exceptionally high standard of living. The Bucks selection of Oshkosh for its D-League team reinforces our reputation as a great place to live, work, play, and learn. Oshkosh is on the cusp of reestablishing itself as a preeminent city in the state of Wisconsin. We will make our community a place that our children will be proud to call home. The Sawdust District, with the arena and D-League team as a cornerstone, are major steps towards fulfilling this vision for our children. I'm sort of the historian on the city council, not because of my age, but I've lived here forever, but Oshkosh is experiencing a boom again. We were a boom town 107 years ago because of lumber. We are now a boom town again because of the citizens of Oshkosh and their enthusiasm to make this just a great, great city. There's development. Everywhere you look, there's something being redeveloped in the city and the riverfront. Now with the Sawdust District, it is a boom town. So. Now, I wish the best of luck to you and your team, and I can't wait for the first game I'll be taking my 2.5-year-old, 3-year-old grandson to it. With that, I would like to introduce City Manager Mark Roloff. Thank you.
Okay, I got to lower the microphone. Just bear with me, okay? Enough of the short jokes, although I got a story for you. You always know you're going to get a story with me. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Mark Roloff. I'm the city manager for the city of Oshkosh. I am hired by the mayor and the members of the Common Council to manage the day-to-day affairs of the city, and I was the lucky one that got to work with Greg on a regular basis for this project. Probably one of the most fun projects of my entire career, so thank you. You put me through a lot of sweat, but a lot of fun. There have been a lot of people who have been asking me, when is this happening? When are the Bucks coming? Because this has been going on for such a long time. And I said, I've got this old tie that I'm going to put on, and the day I'm wearing it, it's a basketball tie, you'll know today's the day. So I've been waiting to put this tie on for a bunch of months now, so I'm real happy. So the story that goes along with this, I got this tie from my kids years ago when I was assistant coach for my son's fifth grade basketball team. And with all due respect to Coach Kidd and his wonderful coaching staff, I make an ideal fifth grade assistant basketball coach. Because when they're short a kid, I'm the perfect big tall guy to block up the paint. So the die's well worth it, and I always have a story for that. And now the memory's gonna be that I was here the day that the Bucks D-League team came here to Oshkosh. So another great day to look forward to. The mayor and Greg have talked a lot about so many people who are involved in this. And I'm looking across the room, and there are so many people who provided just a small slice of assistance to make this project go. And I'm looking at so many different people. Tom Castle and his Uncle Mike, they were the ones who had the boat the day we took the tour. Tour along the river to see everything. The city staff dealing with just a site that has been around for 150 years, and there's a lot of challenges with that site, and we're overcoming those challenges, and we're discovering new ones. Fortunately, environmental is not one of them. Whew, thank goodness. That was already taken care of long before we were showing off the site. But I encourage you to take a look at the drawings we have for the Sawdust District. We used to be known as Sawdust City many years ago, as the mayor mentioned, our lumber history. And we've transformed that. And we're transforming our downtown into something new, a place that can attract families and young people that want to live downtown, want a wonderful nightlife. This will add to that quality of life that we've been lacking, and we're going to get from that. So thank you to the Bucks organization for seeing the vision that we put out there, and they bought into it. I can't believe they did. They did, though. That's wonderful. But we've got a great community of people. Carlene Grabner was the first one who said, you got to talk to this guy, Greg Pierce. He's got this idea about a basketball team. And I was like, seriously? On the Buckstaff site. Well, we had had some ideas for the Buckstaff site. But when Greg shared his vision of what he saw for that site, Greg's footprint is on this site. And the footprint of so many people in this community who have such trust and belief in what we can get accomplished in Oshkosh. So take a look at that, ask questions, because this is a conceptual idea. We have the first stool of for this site. We've got office complexes. We've got the next, second most question I get is the Pioneer site. When are you going to redo the Pioneer? It's coming, and it's coming because we've got the first leg of the stool, the Pioneer's the next leg, and then the remainder of this site will develop because investors in Oshkosh recognize the value for the south side of the South Shore area. So we're looking forward to that. Thank you to Peter and John and Marvin and everyone involved from the Milwaukee Bucks organization, my council members, my mayor, and this great community that puts so much behind this, and now the work begins. So thank you very much.
So I now have the privilege to introduce somebody who's become a workmate, a friend, and the mayor of Milwaukee. The problem, it's under false pretense. I think when he told me a couple weeks ago, hey, I'd love to pass the torch to Mayor Cummings. I'd love to tell him about how we embarked on this and how we're cities and trust. What he really was doing when I came up today was telling Mayor Cummings, tag, you're it. You deal with the Bucks for the next few weeks to do it. Well, no such luck. Mayor Barrett and Mayor Cummings now are glued to us. They're part of the fabric of our team. And it gives me great honor to introduce the mayor of Milwaukee, Mr. Tom Barrett.
Thank you, Peter. Thank you, Peter. Well, good afternoon. So I'm here, I feel like I'm an in-law, to vouch for this family. Because it was almost 3 years ago when the Bucks came to Milwaukee and said, we're going to be something special with the new ownership team. And like many Wisconsinites, I was thinking, I'll believe it when I see it. Well, now 2.5 years later, I believe it. And I'm telling you, you should believe it. Because these guys are for real. They care about community. They understand the need to have the community and the basketball team as part of the same family. And Mayor Cummings, congratulations to you, to Mr. Roloff, to everybody. And especially my hats off to Greg Pierce, because the other part of this that I want you to understand is how important this has been to the city of Milwaukee. The location for the new Bucks Arena, if you're familiar with Milwaukee, is essentially a place where there was an old expressway that was torn down, and that land was lying dormant for many, many years. And they took a risk. And what's happening right now, in a very positive way, we are seeing economic development explode in that part of the city of Milwaukee. So this can do the same thing, as Greg was saying, for Oshkosh. And I look at the Sawdust District and I think the potential is there. You've got the same ingredients. You've got a former industrial site. You've got the water. People love the water. You are going to see more investment because of this. So it's going to bring the community closer together. It's going to bring, I think, more jobs. It's going to make downtown Oshkosh and the heart of Oshkosh a more desirable place, just as has happened in the city of Milwaukee. So I'm here to say again, welcome to the family. It's a great family. And just invite us back for Thanksgiving. Thank you very much. Yeah.
The good news is we're close to the end, which is great. But there's some really important stuff. We've got great news to announce that part of our family and our partnership from the Milwaukee Bucks. This is the first official announcement of a partnership with the BMO Harris Bank and the Fox Valley Basketball as a first official sponsor of this basketball team. And so I wanted to take a moment and really thank BMO Harris Bank. Are the representatives here from the family right here in the beginning? So this, unlike any other D-League team, is on day one, we have a partner entrusted in the community to back us up, which just is incredible news. So we wanted to thank BMO Harris Bank as being here as unbelievable partners. So now the fun stuff. Let me start introducing some of our family, which quickly becomes your family. I just wanted Bob Dandridge, Desmond Mason, Sidney Moncrief, Fred Rogers, and Vin Baker to stand up, who's part of, and Fred Roberts to stand up and introduced us. So the one common theme here is incredible enthusiasm, incredible appetite for growth, and boy, even more of an appetite to get this going. So officially, let the ball game begin. Welcome to Oshkosh, the Milwaukee Bucks. Thank you.